In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace be with you. Well, good evening to you all. Welcome to our Wednesday evening Eucharist and second Lent address for this evening, based on the musical Jesus Christ Superstar. And we offer our Eucharist tonight to the praise and glory of Almighty God, with special intention for all those involved in space exploration, seeking to understand more about this wonderful universe that God has made. Father of glory, holy and eternal, look upon us now in power and mercy. May your strength overcome our weakness, your radiance transform our blindness, and your Spirit draw us to that love, shown and offered to us by your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Compassion and forgiveness belong to the Lord our God, though we have rebelled against him. Let us then renounce our willfulness and ask his mercy by confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Heavenly Father, we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and have failed to do what we ought to have done. We are sorry and truly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and lead us in his way to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you and set you free from sin. Strengthen you in goodness and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you show to those who are in error the light of your truth, that they may return to the way of righteousness. Grant that all who are admitted into the fellowship of Christ's religion may reject those things that are contrary to their baptism, and follow in the way of Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the prophecy of Jeremiah. The people said, "Come, let us make plots against Jeremiah. For instruction shall not perish from the priest, nor counsel from the wise, nor the word from the prophet. Come, let us bring charges against him, and let us not heed any of his words. Give heed to me, O Lord, and listen to what my adversaries say. Is evil a recompense for good? Yet they have dug a pit for my life. Remember how I stood before you, to speak good for them, to turn away your wrath from them." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response to the psalm is, "My trust is in you, O Lord. My trust is in you, O Lord. Take me out of the net that they have laid secretly for me, for you are my strength. Into your hands I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, O Lord God of truth. My trust is in you, O Lord. But my trust is in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God. My times are in your hand. My trust is in you, O Lord. Deliver me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Make your face to shine upon your servant and save me for your mercy's sake. My trust is in you, O Lord. Lord, let me not be confounded, for I have called upon you. But let the wicked be put to shame. Let them be silent in the grave. My trust is in you, O Lord. Let the lying lips be put to silence that speak against the righteous with arrogance, disdain, and contempt. My trust is in you, O Lord.
The Lord be on my heart and on my lips, and will proclaim his holy gospel.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Listen to the Gospel of Christ according to St. John. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were six stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. He said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. When the steward tasted the water that had become wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first and then the inferior wine after the guests have become drunk. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this, the first of his signs, in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Now comes that nerve-wracking moment in the service, at least for me anyway, where I try and work the technology. So, everybody fingers crossed. It worked before the service.
Jesus, I am overjoyed to meet you face to face. You've been getting quite a name all around the place. Healing cripples, raising from the dead. Now I understand you're God. At least that's what you've said. So, you want the crust? You're the great Jesus Christ. Prove to me that you're divine. Change my water into wine. That's all you need to. Then I'll know it's all true. Come on, King of the Jews. Jesus, you just won't believe the hit you've made around here. You are all we talk about. You are the wonder of the year. Oh, what a pity if it's all a lie. Still, I'm sure that you can rock the cynics if you try. So if you are the Christ, yes, the great Jesus Christ, prove to me that you're no fool. Walk across my swimming pool. If you do that for me, then I'll let you go free. Come on, King of the Jews.
So that was Herod from Jesus Christ Superstar singing to Jesus there. And I wonder how many people today would echo those words of Herod. Prove to me that you're divine, change my water into wine. And then again he says, or sings, prove to me that you're no fool, walk across my swimming pool. And then later, a bit we didn't hear, he goes, so if you are the Christ, yes, the great Jesus Christ, feed my household with this bread, you can do it on your head. Be glad I didn't sing to you. Now, there are many miracles, of course, recorded in the Gospels that Jesus did. They range from the ones mentioned by Herod, such as turning water into wine, which I read to you from the Gospel tonight, walking on the water, feeding the 5,000, to healing people of all manner of diseases or disabilities, such as leprosy, blindness and deafness, or being paralysed, and even raising people back to life who had died, such as the widow's son at Nain, Jairus' daughter, or Jesus' friend Lazarus. Now, the fact that there are so many miracles shows us that the gospel writers clearly thought they were an important part of what Jesus was doing on earth. Yet for many people today, believing that such miracles could happen or did happen seems far-fetched. This is especially so in our modern-day scientific world. Maybe like Herod, people would believe if we could replicate the miracles of Jesus today. I read recently of a rather eccentric priest. I must be careful because I'm sure that many people would describe me as such. But anyway, this rather eccentric priest who was in the news and reckoned that the reason for the decline in attendance in church in recent years was due to the church clinging on to outdated belief in miracles. Now, this seemed to me rather an odd argument. His approach seemed to be to say to people, come to church, here's the Bible, but actually we've ditched half of it. Now, I don't know about you, but if I was a skeptic, that sort of approach wouldn't really convince me. So what are we to make then of the miracles of Jesus, and why don't they seem to happen nowadays? Well, as with most topics, it helps, I think, if we get to the basics and then work from there. What is the essence of our faith? The essence of our faith, surely, is that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. He was crucified, speared in the stomach, laid in a tomb, sealed with a massive stone, and then 3 days later he was alive again. Now that seems to me to be a pretty impressive miracle. And if we ditch our belief in the resurrection, as that priest suggested we ought to, then there's really no point being here at all. So if we accept that God can raise a man from the dead, we should accept that he can do all the other stuff as well. But what's the point of that foundational miracle, the resurrection? Is it just an impressive stunt or a conjuring trick with bones, as another eccentric bishop in that case said? Well, of course not. The resurrection teaches us so much about God and his ways. The resurrection teaches us that death does not have the final say in our world. It teaches us that good will triumph over evil in the end. And it teaches us that God promises to raise each of us from the dead, just as he did with Jesus. The resurrection teaches us that we can all have a share in eternal life. It's all about overturning the current world order and holding out the promise of something better. Now, if this is what the major miracle, the resurrection, teaches us, then all the other miracles surely must be leading towards that or pointing towards that in some way. Each miracle then must teach us some aspect of the big promise. So, for example, the water into wine miracle is all about the ability of God to transform situations for the better. The feeding of the 5,000 is surely pointing towards a world where no one goes hungry and all have enough to eat. The various healings, I always think, have a double meaning. Frequently in Jesus' day, being ill or disabled also meant being shunned by society. Think, for example, of the leper colonies, where people with that disease were forced to live outside the city. So not only do the healing miracles point to a world where illness and disability is no more, they also suggest that God's will is for everyone to be included within the community. Now, my current lockdown binge watch is a series called The Man in the High Castle on Amazon Prime. If anybody's seen that, familiar with that? It represents an alternate reality where the Nazis actually won World War II and conquered North America. But the characters in this show become aware of another parallel world where things turned out the other way and the Allies won. Now, they get to know about this other world thanks to newsreel films smuggled back by people who've been able to travel there. Now, the Nazis in the main story become obsessed with travelling to this other world to conquer it as well. They discover a portal which allows them to do so, and they build a special machine to help. The good guys in the drama are racing to stop them. Now, it's as though the miracles of Jesus are like the newsreel film of that other world in the series. They prove to us it exists, and they show us what it's like. It is the perfect world that God wants for all of us, and we call it the kingdom of God. Now, in the show I talked about, many of the characters are understandably sceptical that an alternative world can exist until they actually meet people who've travelled back from there. Now, we have just such a traveller, Jesus. In dying upon the cross and being raised again, he passed into that other reality. But he then came back to tell us and show us what it's like. And we don't need a portal or a special machine to gain access to the kingdom. We experience it every time we invoke the name of Jesus, every time we meet for worship, and every time we break bread together around his table. So the question shouldn't really be, did the miracles of Jesus actually happen? Of course they did. The question should be, what do they teach us today? And they teach us what it means to be a part of God's kingdom, a kingdom we are called upon to try and build in the here and now. Just to go back for a moment to where we started, many people today might ask, why don't miracles happen today? Well, I for one think that a fertilised egg inside a woman's body developing into a human being capable of love, laughter and intelligence is a pretty amazing miracle. So is the way in which flowers grow and trees bud every spring. So is the fact that the earth keeps turning to give us day and night. I suppose it all depends on what you class as a miracle and where you look for them. They definitely happen if only we have eyes to see, and they demonstrate the awesomeness of our God. Amen. Gweddion, let us pray. Mighty God, our Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you that you've promised to hear us when we pray to you in faith. We give you thanks tonight for the miracles of Jesus, which provide us with a window onto your world and your kingdom, where everything has been transformed. Help us to trust in you, and to trust that that kingdom will one day come over all the world. We pray for your church throughout the world, and today especially for the Diocese of Aru in the Congo. Also for our own diocese, for June, our bishop, and all the clergy and people. Today we're asked to pray especially for the bishop's chaplain, Sarah Rogers. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our world, that each in our own way we may continue to build your kingdom by seeking to eliminate poverty, suffering, war, and disease. We give you thanks for all men and women of goodwill seeking to build a better future for our planet. And with our prayer intention today, we remember those also who are exploring other worlds beyond our own. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for this parish and all its people. Particularly today, we pray for all who live in David Street, Plas Dafydd, Meirion Street and Gadlys Uchaf. We hold before you those who are ill in body, mind or spirit, and all those who need our prayers at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks, O Lord, for those who have gone before us in this life, who have now passed through this world into the next world. Among the recently departed, we pray for Nigel Morgan, Christopher Davis, John Stone, Alan Roberts, and Margaret Morgan, and for those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time, especially Janet Edmonds and Elvid Roberts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Once we were far away from God, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of his blood. Tang nefedd yr arglwydd a fo gydwch chi bob amser, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God for ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God for ever. Lord, be pleased to accept the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, it is our duty and our joy, at all times and in all places, to give you thanks and praise. Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty Everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, who was tempted in every way, yet did not sin. By his grace we are able to triumph over every evil, and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hear us, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Through him accept our sacrifice of praise, and grant that by the power of your Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be for us his body and his blood. Who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come in glory. Therefore, Father, remembering the saving death and resurrection of your Son, we offer to you in thanksgiving this bread and this cup, your gifts to us, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send your Holy Spirit upon all of us who share this bread and this cup. Strengthen our faith, make us one, and welcome us and all your people into the glorious kingdom of your Son. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, Honour and glory are yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, we boldly pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, for we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. The body of Christ. Amen. The blood of Christ. Amen. So we stand for our concluding prayers. Diolchwch i'r arglwydd oherwydd graslon wef. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious. Generous God, you have fed us at your heavenly table. Kindle us with the fire of your Spirit, that when the Lord comes again, we may shine as lights before him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Christ give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.